Hello students, welcome to the channel again. This is part 2 of analysis of recent UGC NET English exam which was conducted on 6 December 2019. As I told in part 1, there are many questions related to chronology, so this time try to be apt with the dates. Let us begin the video and please do not forget to share and subscribe my channel. Literature and Shakespeare. These two words seem to be synonym of each other. Whenever anybody talks about literature, Shakespeare is the only word that first strikes to the mind. So here also UGC NET people are not missing Shakespeare. The question, which of the following character in Shakespeare's Love's Labour Lost overuses formal Latinate diction? Option number 3, Costard, is the right option. Love's Labour Lost is one of William Shakespeare's very early comedies and it is believed to have been written in mid-1590s somewhere. Costard is shown to be a comic figure in the play and Costard pokes fun at upper class throughout the play, and while mocking a pedantic schoolmaster, he uses a very big word also. Next question, again chronological, some of the important world texts are given here like German grammar, comparative grammar, an investigation into origin of Old Norse and concerning the conjugation system. According to me, the correct chronological order is DCAB, D being published in 1816, C 1818, A 1822 and B 1854, but I do not see here any option which says DCAB, so I think benefit of doubt should be given to the students over this question. Next question, which of the following periods of English literature is also called Puritan Interregnum? The Commonwealth period, also known as Puritan Interregnum, so option 4 is the right option. It is a literary epoch influenced by English historical context between 1649 and 1660. The Commonwealth was the political structure during the period from 49 to 60, as I told, when England and Wales, later along with Ireland and Scotland, were governed as a republic after the end of Second English Civil War and the trial of execution of Charles I. Next question, in the following list, which two actors belong to Elizabethan period? Richard Burbage, Will Kempe, David Garrick or John Campbell? According to me, the correct option is option number 3, A and B, Richard Burbage and William Kempe. Richard Burbage was an English stage actor who is widely considered to have been one of the most famous actors of Globe Theatre, which belonged to Shakespeare, and he was the younger brother of Cuthbert Burbage also, and they were both actors in dramas of Shakespeare. Next, William Kempe, commonly referred to Will Kemp, was an English actor and dancer specializing in comic roles and is best known for having been one of the original players in the early dramas by, again, William Shakespeare. Next one, who made the remark, great literature is simply language charged with meaning to the utmost possible degree? Options here given are Rabindranath Tagore, Ezra Pound, W.B. Yeats or T.S. Eliot. So option number 2 here is the correct option, Ezra Pound. Ezra Pound was an expatriate American poet and critic and a major figure in the early modernist poetry movements. Next question, from whose work did John Milton take the epigraph to his Areopagitica? Sophocles, Euripides, Plato or Moore? Option number 2, Euripides, is the correct option. Areopagitica is a 1644 prose by English poet, scholar and author John Milton opposing licensing and censorship. The epigraph is from Euripides' play, The Suppliants. This question belongs to Indian literature. Which of the following books carried the additional title Sermon on the Sea? Option number 3, Hind Swaraj or Indian Home Rule by Gandhi is the correct option. Gandhi, as everybody knows, was the leader of new famous non-cooperation movement for national independence and self-development, and is regarded as one of the greatest eminent figure of all time. Sermon on the Sea, sometimes entitled Indian Home Rule or Hind Swaraj, written by Gandhi in South Africa in 1909, reveals his views on civilization and on soul force. The next question. Which three of the following poets figured in William Dunmer's Lament for the Makers? Geoffrey Chaucer, John Gower, Robert Henderson or William Langland? The correct option is option number 2, A, B and C. Let us gather some more information about the question. William Dunmer was a Scottish poet active in late 15th century and the early 16th century, and he was closely associated with the court of King James IV. The Lament of for the Makris or Makers is a poem in the form of Macabre by Scottish poet William Dunmer, transition from life to death, and what the human response to those changes should be. Death is shown as a central concern in this poetry, and the Makris means makers or poets. The original poem is a form of dance macabre or dance of death, in which people of all social classes are summoned by death, and there is mention of few very famous figures, and out of these options A, B and C, that is Chaucer, Gower and Henderson, are mentioned in this poetry. The next one, which three of the following writers are associated with kitchen sink drama? The options are Arnold Weaker, John Arden, Shelley Delaunay and John Osborne. The kitchen sink drama, let us understand first. The kitchen sink drama changed the trajectory of British theatre, and kitchen sink drama realism is a British cultural moment that developed in late 1950s and you can say early 1960s in theatre, arts, novels, films and television plays, and these are the kind of dramas whose protagonists usually could be described as angry young men who were disillusioned with modern society, who were angry with the modernism. And though many of the authors considered to have written in this genre, such as Osborne, Arnold, Wesker, Shelley, Delaunay and John Arden, but they never claimed the title of kitchen sink dramatist. And these authors play contained themes of common life that deeply resonated with British culture of the period. These type of plays signaled a resolute shift of British theatre into the 20th century poetry, although according to me all of these are somehow related to kitchen sink drama, but the most probable option that I will go with is option number 4, that is A, C and D, because John Arden was not actively a writer of kitchen sink drama kind of plays. I can find options of Wesker's play of kitchen sink drama in form of Roots, written in 1959, Shelley Delaunay, A Taste of Honey, it is also considered to be a kitchen sink drama, and John Osborne's play, most famous play, Look Back in Anger, 1956, is a perfect example of kitchen sink drama. So I will go with option number 4, A, C and D, leaving out John Arden. I hope you liked the video. I'll continue to provide the answer to all literary questions of this paper in subsequent parts. Please share and subscribe my channel, and best of luck for your results.